let me show you how you can create a set of social media images for your product and also videos with Weavy and quite a simple setup. Let's jump right in. This is the setup. You can see that in the end, I end up with set of videos and banners that are already, I think, ready to go. They are in square, 4x5, 9x16, and also some close-ups here. I already have a similar workflow, but it's built on Runway, not Nano Banana. But since this model is quite capable, I really wanted to try it with this model also, but you can check that workflow also somewhere here or here. And now let's take a deeper look. Again, I need a product, I need a setting where it will appear. I just removed the background, scaled it to perfect rectangle, and let AI to describe the image. I did the same here, where I let it describe the setting and width. And all those partial descriptions were plugged into prompt concatenator, where it created the base prompt, and I added something I wanted to have there, which is volumetric fog, dramatic high key lighting, and stuff like that. You basically can delete this part if you don't want anything special in it, but I like that. And now I used Nano Banana, where I plugged in this prompt and also image of our shoe. I also could plug in this image, but I don't want it to use this exact place. I just want it to be influenced by the style. Therefore, I let it describe and only use description. I think it fits the workflow better. Here we have our merged image, which is quite fine, I think. But since it's just 1024 by 1024, I wanted to outpaint it into like nice 1080p by 1080p. So it's a square version. Then again, 4x5. I just outpainted pixels above and below. Then I upscaled the square version here, so it's like 4000 pixels on each side. But this way I could create some close-ups here, one with the product located in the lower part, another one with the product located in the upper part. And here it's just something like a simple Photoshop, where I composited my generated image with assets I uploaded before. There is just a text layer, text layer, text layer. Then there is a line, there is a logo, which is not loaded right now, not sure why, but it's there, and like a dark and gradient. With this, let's open, for example, this one. I have plugged in my background, then some text layer, positioned it where I wanted it to be. Again, my logo disappeared, but I probably deleted it somehow. Let's not obsess over it. You can see in the videos that it was there, so I'm not lying. And I did the same thing 5 times with the square, 4x5 portrait, and again with close-up and with these close-ups. Let's think of these nodes as small PSDs in Photoshop. Now I plug those into Kling and Seedance, just maybe to compare the results, which I did, and I think I like Seedance version more. It's like a safer bet, I think, for this step. But in every scenario, it kept the text and logo unchanged. As you can see, logo, line, and also the tagline is untouched in every single image and video. Of course, not every generation will be ready for that use, but some would need to maybe do a second or third round, but you will definitely get there. And if you would like to use it for your product. Just change this image, plug it here and let it run one by one. And again, change environment, plug it here, let it run one by one, and change those texts to maybe be whatever you need it to be, and upload your logo here. Again, quite a simple workflow, although those wires look really cool and really frightening maybe, but it's not that difficult. If you go one by one from left to right, you will understand it quite easily. So again, you can use it for free, it's in the description, and stay tuned for the next one.